In the previous video, we had seen about the peak to average ratio and what is going to be, how it can be minimized, how what are the procedures to minimize your peak to average ratio we had seen. So now in this video, we will be seeing a single carrier frequency domain equalization. So a single carrier frequency domain equalization is going to have three benefits. One is that it is going to have a low complexity even for multipath channels. It is going to have an excellent bit error rate performance, and it is going to be free from your ISI or other types of interference there. So basically because of your spatial interference, which is going to be used in using your multiple antenna transmission there. So here in this case, a single carrier transmission, the peak to average ratio is also going to be reduced significantly due to multi-carrier modulation there. So here in this case, your single carrier frequency domain equalization is going to utilize this cyclic prefix. So the cyclic prefix is going to be as long as the channel delay spread there. So here in this case, the transmitted signal is just a simple sequence of your quadrature amplitude modulated symbols, which is going to have a low peak to average ratio, which is going to be in the range of 4 to 5 decibels depending on the constellation size. So here the basic block diagram for OFDM and the single carrier FDE are going to be compared. So here in this, we are going to see why you are going to use your single carrier FDE in your uplink, because of the low peak to average power ratio. So here in your OFDM transmitter, the IFFT block was introduced at the transmitter side itself. So here in this case, because it was introduced at the transmitter side, we had a higher peak to average ratio. But in single carrier frequency domain equalization, this IFFT block is going to be used at the receiver side. So by using it at the receiver side, what is the advantages we can have? The low peak to average power ratio there. So here in this case, the unmodulated sine wave, which is going to have the peak to average ratio of 3 decibels. It is clear that the peak to average ratio cannot be lower, must be below in that of an single carrier FDE system there. So here in this case, as in your OFDM system, the FFT is going to be applied. But in your single carrier FDE system, frequency domain equalization system, the operation is going to be moves the received signal into a frequency domain. So from frequency domain, it is going to be sent to a frequency equalizer. From the frequency equalizer, we are going to give it to an IFT block, where the output is going to be a time domain signal. So because of the application of the cyclic prefix, the received signal is going to appear as a circularly convolute. That is y of n is equal to x of n circular convolution x of n plus w of n, where w of n is going to be the noise that is present in the channel there. If I am going to take the FFT of your y of n, then it is nothing but in frequency domain, it is going to represent as y of m is equal to x of m into h of m plus w of m. So after the FFT, I am going to use a single tap frequency equalizer, which can be applied, that is going to invert each virtual carrier. So your x cap of m, the demodulated signal, is going to be y of m divided by x of m. That means that output signal is going to be scaled by the input signal, is record signal is going to be scaled by a factor h of m. So here we are going to use your IFFT operation, where it is going to be used back, converted back, the resulting signal is going to be converted back into your time domain there, which is going to estimate the desired data symbols. So here in this case, your h of m can be estimated the receiver using your pilot signals here. So now we are going to see the comparison between your OFDM and your single carrier FDE. So your OFDM is going to provide a high performance, but in the case of single carrier FDE, it is going to perform relatively less performance there. So in OFDM, you are going to have high peak to average power ratio, but in the CFD, it is going to have low peak to average power ratio there. So in OFDM, the signal to noise ratio of each data symbol is does not change by multiplying the constant factor at the receiver, but the signal to noise ratio of each data symbol is going to change by multiplying the constant factor at the receiver there. So here OFDM is nominally less dispersive spectrum, but in this case it is going to have more dispersive spectrum there. So OFDM is going to have a sharper spectrum, which results in less co-channel interference or less restrictive RF roll-off requirements there. But in single carrier FDE, because of the dispersive medium, spectrum, it is going to have more co-channel interference and is more restrictive to your RF roll-off requirements. So in OFDM, you are going to have the short scale variations in your signal to noise ratio, which will be addressed by coding and interleaving. But in single carrier FDE, the frequency equalizer does not operate on the data symbols themselves, but rather on the frequency domain DL of the data symbols. The noise amplification is going to be isolated in the case of your OFDM, and it does not affect all the symbols prior to decoding and detection. Here the noise amplification is not isolated to a single symbol in single carrier FDE, but instead affects all the symbols prior to decoding and detection. So OFDM continues to be more popular than single carrier FDE. Here it is less popular. These are the differences between a OFDM and a single carrier FDE, frequency domain equalization. So now we are going to see what are the design considerations for a single carrier FDE and a OFDM. So in your OFDM, design wise it is going to be more complex, but a single carrier FDE is going to be less complex. The complexity is going to be, you are going to have a lower complexity receiver in OFDM, but the receiver is going to be highly complex. So your OFDM and the single carrier FDE, it has a medium complexity transmitter, it has a lower complexity transmitter. So the LTE downlink could utilize OFDM, LTE uplink will utilize the single carrier FDE. So the base station as the transmitter would perform 3 IF50 and FFT operations. So here it performs only a single FFT operation at the receiver. The peak to average ratio is high in OFDM and high cost and more power requirement. Here in this case it is going to be of reduced peak to average ratio and the reduced cost and power savings there. So the OFDM, the channel estimation and synchronization are accomplished via a preamble of known data symbols and then pilot tones. So in OFDM, the data are going to be sent based on channel estimation and the synchronization here, and based on the pilot tones there. But in this case, it includes a preamble in the time domain, so it is not a straightforward to estimate the frequency domain values there. So here, in OFDM, the preamble can be inserted at known positions in all subsequent OFDM symbols. In SCFDE, it is not possible to insert the pilot tones on a per frame basis. Hence, it uses DFT and IFFT at the transmitter. OFDM has normally less dispersive spectrum. It has normally more dispersive spectrum. So, OFDM is going to have sharper spectrum, which results in less co-channel interference or less restrictive RF roll-off requirements. In SCFDE, it is due to dispersive spectrum, results in more co-channel interference and more restrictive RF roll-off requirements. The combination of OFDM and MIMO is a natural and best combination for performance improvement in a fading channel. The combination of SCFDE with MIMO is not as natural because detection cannot be done in frequency domain. Not possible to use maximum likelihood detection for MIMO with SCFDE. On the whole, OFDM continues to be much more popular than SCFDE, which is less popular than OFDM.